Get off my lawn! Let's see here.
And we're off! Hey, if you do find a way out of the city, you'll come back and rescue us, right?
Come back? To Sunset City? Why would I?
Of course you'll come back and save us. You're you! I'm sorry. I don't even know why I questioned it. So this will take a few hours to finish. I'll let you know when it's done.
Floyd, I'm ready for another cook. Come on back when you're ready.
Copy that, science guy.
Hey, looks like you got all the ingredients we need. Don't lose them on the way back.
Oh, look. Some guys who are about to be dead.
I got a situation here. I need to move my operation to the construction yard down the street, but it's full of freaks. Can you, like, clear the shit out of the place? Oh, and if you see any scabs, don't say anything about me, okay? Fuckers beat me up and, well, let's just say we got history.
Thank you.
poppers.
Use a hand with some of this equipment. Come on, help a brother out.
This is pure ethanol. Dangerous shit. But I need it to make my special recipe.
Oh, shit! The scabs found me. Don't let them take me. Use your guns and shit. You can even use my ethanol. It's a super dope explosive. Pick up one of those barrels and chuck it at them.
I'm gonna go hide, yo. Blow the shit out of those scab holes.
We know you're here somewhere, Jess!
Come on out! We just want to keep you
calm! Science, bitch!
On your own. We own the whole market.
I make a superior product.
Hey, I just got in some new products. Find me and we'll make a deal.
Some rewards and shit. I'm gonna get set up and start brewing the best batch of vodka ever. Then I think I'll have myself a nice blue velvet martini, yo.
Thank you.
traps outside the base. I ran out of time setting them up. Can you finish the job for me? Set up a few more hack and slay traps around that barricade.
Get out to the front of the base. I've been messing around with some trap designs. Just uploaded the plans for a new trap to your phone. Hack and slay traps will chop up any OD that get near it. Those hack and slay traps won't hurt you, don't worry. I just uploaded the flingborn trap to your phone. This trap will send enemies back to where they came from. Be sure to point it away from the base. Switch to the flingborn trap, then place it. Gotta keep an eye on your power usage. Each time you place a trap, it will use up some power. When we're out, we're out. You can always remove traps to get power back. Keep an eye on your traps. The OD can destroy them. If a trap is destroyed, you'll get power back. Power grid is at max capacity. Place as many traps as you can. These traps should be good for tonight, but we'll need better ones soon. I'm no engineer. Am I? Well, there might be other survivors out there who know how to build better traps. So look around when you're out in the city. When you're done placing traps, turn that valve and we'll get down to business.
Ha!
Thanks, Floyd. Good job cowering, by the way.
Don't give those amps a spin!
I think his name's Walter. He came in, said he knows you, so I gave him your propeller.
What?
He looked kinda pissed.
Yeah, that's Walter.
Hey, kid. Nice try with the propeller, but you fucked it up. Meet me at the overpass.
God damn it.
Working my ass off to repair this thing, then you go behind my back and make a new propeller. You looking to steal my glider?
No, it wasn't like that. I'm
fucking with you, kid. Can't you see me smiling?
Ha ha.
It's a fine propeller. We're almost ready to fly out of here. The only problem is, a few minutes ago, some scabs stumbled across the glider. I held them off, but they stole my glide wheel.
Glide wheel? Sounds made up.
Well, how about you make yourself up a way to get it back? And hurry, those scabs will be back soon. I'll wait here. I saw the scabs heading towards the amphitheater, down by the waterfront.
That gang of scabs. That's where the glide wheel is. There's the glide wheel. I think. I better get back to Walter before he has a stroke. Or something else old people get and then die. Yeah.
them off. Show up.
Smokestack updraft to give us enough of a boost to escape.
Okay, now how do I go up and down? Good to know, thanks. Anything else?
loaded this thing with some weapons. Give them a try.
Follow that ship!
What is that?
That's a Fisco patrol ship. It ID'd your glider and is alerting Fisco reinforcements. You guys will be shot down for sure if you try to escape now.
Who is this?
It's Sam! And you guys are in big trouble!
What do we do, Sam?
You can't shoot it down. It's got shields, but... maybe...
Maybe what, Sam?
Huh? Oh, sorry, I was checking Reddit. Follow the patrol ship. If you chase it through the city to my location, I can upload a virus to it and take out the shields. But you gotta get pretty close. And I gotta code the virus first.
Okay, we'll follow the ship.
Watch out for the mine!
Sam, how's that virus coming?
Don't bother me when I'm coding.
I can really use a donut. A donut would help me think. Maybe Boston cream. Oh, that's a good donut.
We'll miss you. You cranky motherfucker.
I'm sorry, Floyd. Just wish I could have saved him.
Best thing you can do is keep being yourself. Keep that swagger going. Cool?
Yeah.
Hey, Walter talked about this guy named Brill Cream. Says he was the smartest guy around. You find that guy, I bet he'll figure out how to escape the city.
Brill Cream? What kind of a name is that?
One that's easy to remember, I guess. Anyway, Walter said there was ham radio signals coming from a Japanese museum nearby. Might be him. You should check it out. I bet you're wondering how Walter and I ended up together.
I just assumed you were twin brothers. So many similarities.
We met at a party. Or was it the DMV? I can't remember. Anyway, one thing I do remember is Walter didn't judge me for how I looked, how I talked, how I dressed. He told me, don't judge people, judge their actions. He was kind of a zen motherfucker that way, and I loved him for it. He and I talked about you a lot.
Uh-oh, my character moment sense is tingling.
There's something special about you. But it's buried beneath a whole lot of wise ass.
Oh, gee whiz, thanks for the revelation, Freud. Damn it, I just proved your point, didn't I?
Like I said, man, I don't judge people, just their actions. My point is, don't let you get in the way of yourself.
Did you just cook up a philosopher amp or something?
I'm here for you.
Here you go. Chock full of secret crap.
Perfect. More scabs.
Thank you.
marching in the parade during the overcharge party, and I guess they all got chased to the Japanese Museum.
What do you mean, senior troop?
These aren't all little kids, roasting marshmallows, and tying knots. They're older, more focused on life skills, volunteering, conservations, and shit like that.
So basically, the anti-me.
Hey, you said it, not me.
These traps. Nice designs. Grill Cream? Hello? He's inside. Will not be defeated by a locked door. Plan B, to the roof! I'm a ninja breaking into a Japanese museum.
How did you get in here?
I'm looking for a guy named Brill Cream.
Troopmaster Brill Cream is missing.
Well, maybe I can help you find him.
Maybe you'll be lucky if I let you live.
Kind of a dick, huh?
Treason! Arrest for Kim and banish her from the troop!
Chill out, Mussolini.
I am the troop master, and this is my troop.
Man, are you gonna tell me where Brill Cream is or what?
You wanna find Brill Cream? You must do as I say.
God, this is bad. I broke a cat. It says right on there that if you break one, you'll have a lifetime of bad luck. Unless you replace it with, like, a bunch more. I don't want bad luck for the rest of my life. You gotta help me. There's a group of scabs over by the mall. I think they might have some.
Everybody got that? Hey, raise your hand if you need me to go over it again.
Yeah.
careful. I think those scabs are using lucky cats to make bombs. How stupid is that?
Yeah.
They're gonna have bad luck for, like, forever.
Make sure your health insurance is up to date. Just a scratch. Yep. I'm coming for you, scabs. I think I'll give these scabs a little destructive criticism.
Luck feels like.
I'm gonna kill you!
Style, it's utterly you.
Everybody got that?
Take care of that radio
hey,
tower.
Hey, I have something new. Just your style.
Take nothing but pictures, leave nothing but
glad to see you. Pretty dangerous out there, huh? Well, as long as you're out there, you mind grabbing some comics for me? I'll totally make it worth your while.
I just remembered, my buddy Jason was a bus driver. I think I might have given him one. This is great. Jason was dead, wasn't he? That's okay. You know, as I always say, comics are more important than friends. It'll be awesome if you could find some more, though. I'm so stupid. I can't believe I forgot about Trina. She used to be my girlfriend, but then we had this super big blow-up about Captain Thunder's origin story and whatever. I was right. Anyway, she worked at the hotel down the road. Maybe you could find it there. Yeah. It was this guy, Terry. Kind of sketchy, and the BO on that guy. Jesus. I think he joined a gang of scabs. Huh. See, the thing is, I borrowed some comics from this guy, Anton. Then I lent them to some of my friends, but I forgot which friends, and this guy, Anton, he's gonna kill me if he finds out I don't have his comics. Seriously, I think he, like, kills people for a living.
Scabs fighting Fizco? I call winner!
Oh, I just remembered, I have this buddy Mike who works construction. Huge comic geek. Like, every day at lunch, he would go read at the same place. So, maybe he left it there?
Thank you.
just remembered Anton was right next door the whole time. Sorry. Anyway, come get your reward. Hey, I was thinking about this whole apocalypse thing. So, lots of people died, and it's really sad. So, why should their comics go to waste, right? A bunch of our regular customers had really good collections, and they lived in the area, so go rescue those lonely comics.
Happening.
a comic about you, and then do a video game spin-off. Then you could cosplay as yourself. That is so meta. Okay, that's everyone on the list. Bring them back, and I'll get them all in slipcovers.
Some new products. Find me and we'll make a deal.
Nice. Here, I found this in the back closet. It'll totally make you look like a superhero. You can be like the superhero who liberates comic books during the mutant apocalypse. That would be an amazing comic. Hey, I got this story idea. Check it out, okay? You're the Comic Knight, upholder of the comics code and defender of comics in the apocalypse. What do you think? It's awesome, huh? I draw it up, but I can't draw or write. But I love reading. I got some leads on some more. You know, if you're truly the hero this city needs. Shipped out a bunch of books the week before the city turned. As Comic Knight, it's really your duty to liberate them from the clutches of the enemy and return them to good owners, like me.
Stick with Comic Knight.
Yeah, cool. Okay.
Thank you.
good. Yeah, and it appeals to girls, too. Your comic is going to be such a hit.
About a villain.
Yes, a villain. Someone who hates comics, like my ex. Just kidding. Not really. I actually never had a girlfriend, whatever. Anyway, I gotta think about this. Just keep up that first edition Justice Comic Night. Right? Maybe you used to be lovers or whatever, but then she had like a freak drowning accident, and now she's only being kept alive by a symbiotic mold. An evil mold. And the mold is in her head, making her totally crazy. I can see the movie already.
Kill.
Nemesis. I mean, think about what would happen if her musty mildewness ever got near your magic comic. Who knows if kitty litter and baking soda could even bring the magic back. Restore your power. Yep. Then we could have a whole series of comeback issues building up to a climactic fight. This could easily be 100 plus issues.
Scratch.
imitating life here?
Any connections here are purely coincidental. This is a monumental tragedy. I mean, she blames the comics. And maybe you secretly blame...
myself?
Oh, no way. No. Ouch. What? No. How could you have known she was suffering all that time? Come on, get back on board with this.
Duck around me.
Ready for this ending?
Definitely not.
So in order to defeat Musty Mildew, the Comic Knight has to sacrifice the very thing he loves most.
The Super Mint Magic Comic.
Yeah. How did you know? Huh. I guess you are the Comic Knight.
Yeah, and I'm not doing it. I've got comics to save. No way I'm giving up my powers for moldy old love.
Wow, you're such an anti-hero. There's so much truth in this art. I'm done collecting. I've got to get to writing all this down. And you, good luck out there, Comic Knight. One man in this town believes in you.
Child, I have new styles here, perfect for your irregular size.
Courage, mercy.
Put that on. I'm sure I'll love it almost as much as you will. I have new creations. Come, drape yourself in my tower. Jeans.
I have a real beauty I might be willing to part with for the right price. You have fun with your top secret map, huh? If you find anything good, send a commission to Two Hat Jack. Enjoy the post-apocalyptic murderscape.
Tower. My troop has been trying to locate Troop Master Brill Cream via radio, but all they hear is this.
Doctors recommend drinking 17 cans of Overcharge a day.
The radio station is located here. If you destroy all three transmitters around the tower, we have a better chance of locating Troop Master Brill Cream. So, you think you can do that?
Sure thing. Be right back.
What is that? Like this? Yeah. Sweet. I didn't even have to check game facts. Guys look tough.
Robots, run!
transmitters blew up so big?
Holy shit! Looks like that kicked the hornet's nest.
Yeah! Hey, Norton. Fixed your radio for you.
What? You're alive?
I'm not gonna lose to a blimp. That'd be humiliating.
Well, my troop thanks you for your service. Goodbye.
Wait. You'll let me know if you find Brill Cream, right?
Oh, yes. Brill Cream, of course. We'll keep looking for it. Thank you again.
Hey, it's Sam. Come back to our base. There's someone here that wants to talk with you. And she's kind of cute.
My name is Forkin.
Hey, sorry about that whole banished from the troop thing.
It's for the best. Troopmaster Norton is a bad guy. Even though he says he's trying to find Brill Cream, he's not. I overheard him whisper something about Troopmaster Brill Cream at the hot dog factory.
I hear this Brill Cream guy is really smart.
He's a genius.
A genius that might be trapped in a hot dog factory?
I'm worried. He's been missing for a couple of weeks.
We'll find him.
You mean I'll find him?
Someone has to stay here and comfort Forkin.
Right. Keep up the good work, Sam.
That Forkin chick is smart. Could have gone to Oxford West.
Hey. You know that big parking garage in old little Tokyo? It's packed with all kinds of electronics we could totally use. But it's scab turf. You know what? You could lure some OD over there to help take care of the scabs. My sociology prof said passive-aggressive warfare is the future.
So what's the deal with the hot dog factory? If you're trying to survive the apocalypse, hot dogs are the last thing you should eat.
Troopmaster Brill Cream is a master at boosting morale. Maybe he thought a hot dog cookout would lift the spirits of the troop.
Oh, that's funny, because I prefer to lift my spirits with actual spirits.
Alcohol is a depressant and has many health risks.
You're right.
Gandhi once said, an eye for an eye will only make the whole world blind. I mean, I'm not saying you need to be Gandhi or the Dalai Lama or whatever. Just pointing out that sometimes there might be a more effective way of getting what you want. Other than shooting everything in the face, that is. Yeah.
Yeah.
smash some vending machines, and set off some car alarms.
Look for more cars or vending machines!
Sorry.
Okay, I'm at the hot dog factory.
Look around for signs of Troopmaster Brook.
Scabs. And it looks like they decided to upgrade their arson.
Where did they get those new weapons? They're not smart enough to design them on their own. You might have to deal with some scabs while you look for evidence.
You think? Scabs and evidence go together like, hot dogs and factories. Troop leader's hat. Seems like something a troop leader would wear.
That could be Brill Creeps. He was always wearing his hat. We need more evidence.
Found a bugle. Now that would only be something a troop leader would have, right?
Rokun carried a bugle, sometimes. But I'm not sure why he would have brought that with him.
Yeah, you're right. This could be anyone's bugle.
I think we just need one more piece of evidence.
You guys sure do things by the book, don't you?
Troopmaster Brillcream teaches us that discipline is the most important virtue.
Discipline? Yeah, I'm unfamiliar with that word.
What idea was it to name this place Sunset City? I ain't seen a sunset yet.
Let's fight! Found a Japanese sword. Not something a troop leader would have.
Yeah, seems weird, doesn't it? But it could be real creeps. We never went anywhere without it.
I feel like that could have been useful intel to have at the top of this caper.
Okay, I'm convinced. Either Brillcream is here, or he was here. You should check inside the factory.
Look at him go! Why can't I move like that?
Brillcream is a trained survivalist. He may have locked himself inside. See if you can find a way to bust down a door, or even a wall. Is there any construction equipment around? Anything that might help you get inside? Use the crane to bust down the wall.
Keys. Wait, cranes have keys? Huh. What would Batman do? Probably read this note out loud. Meet me in the park for a picnic. I love you. Well, that's helpful. Guess I'm going to the park to look for some keys. And maybe even have a date. Hey, 4Kim. Sam's not being too annoying, is he?
not anymore. He kept trying to hold my hand, so I put my judo badge into action and snared him in a rear naked choke.
Nice. But go easy on him. I get the sense he doesn't have much experience with the ladies.
Well, he's been a perfect gentleman since. He showed me around, I fed his friends. He even taught me how to do a little C++ coding.
Wow, sure to invite me to the wedding. I love free food.
Wait, what?
Okay, I found the picnic site. It's like the crane guy either turned OD or was mauled. Damn, I need those keys to the crane.
If we're lucky, he turned OD. Go kill some and see if any of them have the key.
Ah, just what I need. Fizco bots.
grab that crane key.
Doesn't look like any car key I've ever seen. But if this doesn't start the crane and I have to keep running around killing OD and looking for keys, I'll probably rage quit. Hey, Fort Kim, you there?
Yes. Did you find the key?
Yeah, but I have something more important to talk about.
Okay.
So what do you think of Sam? Really?
I don't know why, but he kind of reminds me of this class turtle we had in fourth grade. We set him free in the ocean one day. Then we found out later that he was a freshwater turtle.
Don't tell Sam that story. Charge deliveries. Now this place is about to be stupid with OD.
Good thing I have godlike crushing power.
Better crush those OD before they turn into poppers. Note from Brill Cream. It's dated 2 weeks ago.
What does it say?
It says, hot dog spoiled, heading to Hepcats to meet Norton. Scavs on my trail, we'll try to lose them.
Let's meet at Hepcats and look for more clues. I knew Norton was involved somehow.
Troop Master Norton?
Hey, Norton. How's that search for Brill Cream going?
Not good. I believe it's time to call it off.
Not yet. I'm following up on a lead.
Oh?
I found a note from Brill Cream. He said he was going to meet you at Hepcat's Diner. Whatever happened with that?
Well, as I recall, he never showed up. Where did you find that note?
You're lying, Norton. What are you hiding?
How dare you! A troop master never lies. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have important troop matters to attend to. Meet me at Hepcat's Diner. I think poor Kim could be in trouble.
On my way.
Scabs, go in after her! You gotta get up there!
Wait here.
I'm trying to contact Fort Kim, but her phone is dead. Oh, I hope she's okay.
She probably turned her phone off. Either that or she's sick of your constant texting. Did she at least go armed?
She's always prepared. She had a baseball bat and a book on how to tie knots.
Clever girl. I'm at the bottom of the station. Looks like a whole scab legion is occupying this place.
Mars.
Yes, it's me. Being me.
Good. Keep doing what you're doing. You're a very good distraction. Oh, the scouts are leaving the platform. This is my chance to rescue Brill Cream.
Can you see him?
No, but the SOS signal is coming from the train on the platform.
He turned into a train?
I'm going in.
Wait! I'm almost at the platform. Don't do anything stupid. That's my job.
What's poor Kim doing?
She said she was going to check out the train. Haven't heard from her since. She's probably dead.
What?
I guess there's a chance she's still alive, but I won't know until I get up to the platform.
oil cream is in a garbage truck, but they didn't know where.
Garbage truck, huh? And the whole garbage system is automated. The trucks are equipped with GPS transmitters. If you come back to our base, I might be able to figure out a way to track it down.
Okay, cool. I'm on my way. Wait, how do we communicate with Sam when neither of us is holding a phone?
Technology.
Technology.
Let's not complicate things by poking holes in the way we deliver the story, okay?
Oh, okay then. I'm gonna go back to the base and be magically gone by the time you have control.
Fine by me. That's not weird at all.
Hey, man, I found a new place to set up shop. More square footage, better feng shui. Come on over whenever you get a chance.
I learned a few other things while I was interrogating those scabs. They said they were working with Norton. He was supplying them with plans for upgraded weapons in return for protection.
Asshole! Then he sent them to the train station as soon as he hung up with me.
I would go kick his butt right now, but he has the rest of the troop on his side. The only way we're going to win them over is to find Brill Cream and return him to the troop.
We're working on that right now. I need to do some research into the garbage truck system. Their signals are analog. Ugh. Tough to track down.
Call me when you figured it out.
You bet.
Just came in. I adore that piece. I can't wait to see you in it.
I built something for you because I know you like killing guys so very much. My guns are like my children. I build them, I love them, and I sell them at a good price.
letter? For me?
Want to uncover the truth behind Overcharge? The real truth? Wait for my call at the dog park.
Sounds intriguing. Better head to the dog park. Is that a phone booth, or a public toilet, or both? Hello?
Were you followed?
I don't think so.
Listen close. We're gonna blow the lid off this whole conspiracy. Fisco was supposed to burn all the top secret memos, but one of their admins dropped some into recycling bins instead. Those bins are now inside recycling trucks parked around the city. Get the memos and bring them to the dead drop location.
This is some serious spy movie action. This would be way better with some spy movie music. Now that's more like it.
I'm a nerdy liar.
This is too good.
I win! Yeah, I'm gonna mess you up!
Try something new.
for ammo!
Take these to the dead drop. I just love saying that. Another letter.
Drop the memos off in the dumpster. I'll process them and set up another meeting. We're gonna make Fisco pay for what they did to us.
Okay. Hope Mr. Mysterious knows what he's doing.
One, two, three, four.